Welcome to the Mountain Morning Show. I'm Kyle McEnis, and I am very excited to introduce our newest guest. He is a professional mountain biker and comes to us from New Jersey, Jeff Lenosky. Great to meet you, Jeff.
Yeah, great to be here.
So tell us a little bit about your background and kind of how you got into mountain biking.
I'm a professional mountain bike rider. Started riding bikes as a kid in New Jersey. Nice. I've been riding professionally for 21 years. So riding bicycles in total, well over 30. And it wasn't a very popular sport when I started. I'm not really sure what attracted me to bikes. I saw a BMX bike. I'd got one as a kid, and then a little bit later on saw some magazines in a store, and I would just keep buying BMX magazines as a kid growing up in New Jersey and pursued it all through high school and into college. And the weird thing was, you know, that was before the internet and all that, so the only way to see these sports was through magazines, and it just seemed like everybody that did BMX lived in California and so far away. So I would basically buy a new magazine and try to learn all the tricks before the new magazine came out, and that's
awesome.
Kind of how I stayed engaged in the sport. Then when I was in high school, I skateboarded and rode BMX, and I got pretty tall, I was 6'4", and a mountain bike seemed like a big BMX bike. So I got one of those, and I'd go for shop rides with, you know, different bike shops and stuff, and everybody would always be concerned with how far or how fast they could go. And I would be the guy trying to bunny hop over logs and ride off picnic tables, basically imitating what I did on my BMX bike.
Yeah.
And they just thought I was an idiot until one day I met a friend of mine who's still a good friend to this day, Scott Stewart. He was the Observe Trials champion for the state of New Jersey. Wow. And he was the one who pointed out like that what I was doing was most similar to trials versus cross country or downhill, and then I just kind of directed my career towards that.
That's awesome.
Yeah,
it's an awesome story that the print world, you know, nowadays that's a very rare thing.
All the stuff is so accessible now to kids. So you know, between YouTube and Facebook and Instagram, like if you want to pick up an obscure sport, which is what Observe Trials is, you know, you could follow it all around the world and stuff like that. Whereas back then, you know, it was a magazine once a month. That was it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So what's your earliest memory on a mountain bike or a bicycle?
Probably just building jumps in my backyard and stuff like that. And then some of my earliest memories then when I started to compete would be like taking road trips and stuff like that to go to competitions when I was in college and stuff. And just remember like going to places even as close as like Pennsylvania or Michigan or whatever seemed like worlds and worlds away.
Yeah.
Just traveling to those places. So I really loved like that the bike took me to different places and exploring and stuff like that. But yeah, just the earliest thing would definitely just be riding around town, jumping curbs and, you know, trying to learn those tricks. Yeah, just trying to learn those tricks.
I gotta agree with you there. That's the best. Those are my best memories as well.
Yeah.
But tell our viewers a little bit why you're here in Utah.
So I'm in Utah because I was here for a grand opening of some giant retail partner stores, Taylor's Bike Shops. They have several locations around Salt Lake. So that was one of the reasons I did some live demonstrations.
Nice.
And then also I have a video series that I started doing about a year and a half ago, and it's called Trail Boss. So basically the idea behind Trail Boss is to you know, try to show people that I'm the trail boss, but then also empower them to like be trail bosses themselves. So I travel around, I use MTB Project app and look for double black diamond trails, black diamond trails. So with a lot of these GPS apps nowadays, you could roll into Deer Valley or Park City, mm-hmm. pull up this app and find all the trails in town. So you could choose a green trail, a blue trail, black diamond, just like skiing. They have these programs now that, you know, allow you allow you to find trails and stuff like that. So I try to find the hardest trails that people say are unrideable or unpassable and stuff like that, and I try to ride those trails.
Prove them wrong.
Yeah, so it's a pretty cool project. Awesome. And coming from a trials background, which is, you know, not how far or fast, it's just riding over rough technical terrain, definitely have a lot of technical skills that isn't very common for the average mountain biker. There's probably plenty of guys that could go faster than me, but I pride myself at being a very technical rider.
That's awesome.
And now I just, you know, between the technology of mountain bikes and, you know, just a evolution of my career, the things that you could do on a mountain bike, how far you can go and the terrain you could ride. One of my favorite things to do now is to get on a regular mountain bike, you know, say a Giant Trance, has suspension, it has disc brakes, and you could go for like a 20-mile ride and just ride everything. Whereas when I just did trials, you might just practice on a pile of rocks in a parking lot. You didn't go very far. So now I like to really get out there in the backcountry and like try to find those unrideable challenges.
A little more solitude out there.
Yeah, exactly.
Awesome. Well, you were telling me a little bit earlier about some fun things you have on the horizon here locally in Utah. Can you mention any?
So the Trail Boss journey took me to Utah. I knew I was coming out for the grand openings. I figured it was a great opportunity to explore around here a little bit. So I actually did a road trip. I was at a festival for one of my sponsors in Colorado last weekend, and then we road tripped out to Moab, to Utah. So hit Grand Junction, Colorado on the way, shot a Trail Boss there. There's some really awesome trails there. Can't say what the trails are yet because you'll have to subscribe to my YouTube channel to find
check it out.
Jeff Lenosky Trail Boss. And then we shot one in Moab. Okay. It's pretty much like the ultimate mountain bike destination, so you definitely got to get one there.
Yep.
And then hoping to get one in Deer Valley while I'm still here. So trying to check off all the boxes while I'm in town and ride as many trails as possible.
Awesome.
Yeah.
Awesome. So you mentioned the Trail Boss segment. Is there a specific handle or social media shout outs that you'd like to highlight?
Well, if you follow my Facebook page, they're always hosted on there. So that's just Jeff Lenosky, or actually Ride With Jeff if you want to type in the actual Facebook address. Or my YouTube page is YouTube Jeff Lenosky Trail Boss. And I put out a new video every single week. And then I have the Trail Boss feature films, and those are every 6 weeks. So every 6 weeks we go to like a really, really hard trail, and it's just focusing on me, the ultimate hardest trail I could find. Lots of camera angles and everything. And then every week I do a Trail Boss ride along where I might go with a local celebrity or rider or something like that.
Awesome.
And we just hit a cool trail wherever I happen to be. And you know, we'll have some fun on the trail, but it's just more like a ride along. It's actually called Ride Along, and it is a ride along. We're just hitting some cool, fun trails. So every week there's something new. And then also on Instagram, just Jeff Lenosky as well.
Awesome.
Yeah.
Well, I checked out your videos and I was actually blown away. I didn't know you were a trials rider before I met you, and I could definitely see your trial skills in there. You're cornering and getting over those rock gardens. It's pretty awesome.
Yeah, trials is just such a unique style of riding that, you know, the average rider doesn't really ever, you know, it doesn't make sense to go out and practice how to balance your bike in place or how to hop it or all those things. You know, a normal person gets on a bike and they learn to roll and use momentum and stuff like that, which is great. And I've always prided myself on riding a little bit of everything. So when I first started, I even would compete at cross country and downhill and stuff like that. So I kind of have that background. I just was always best at trials. So when I get into those technical situations and, you know, something gets a little sketchy and you could balance for a second or make a correction hop without having to unclip or whatever, that's when the trial skills definitely come into play and help you clear those sections that, you know, give other people hard times.
The unpassable is passable.
Yeah, sometimes you just gotta throw in a hop or a bunny hop or whatever. So that's where those trial skills definitely pay off.
Awesome. Well, yeah. I wanna thank you for taking the time to stop by. It was great to meet you.
Yeah, really great to meet you.
And thank you for watching Park City Television.